Hey, welcome to TurnoVision. It's time for another Junior Eurovision entry. Today's entry comes from
Malta.
It's Ike and Kaya with the song My Home. And so we're going to take a listen, see what we think to these winners of a national competition.
Let's go.
I like the chair she's sitting in. It's pretty neat.
It feels immediately like Disney. Do you have the Disney vibe?
Very much so. Very much so. A lot of the flowers, the princess feel, the dress. Which one do you suppose this is? Ike or Kaya?
I have no idea.
So, I'm assuming this is Kaya. And she seems like she's very young still. Her voice isn't fully matured. And I think she's got a lot of good charisma and performance to her. She seems more comfortable on that stage than maybe even some of the other performers we've seen.
Oh, wow. Didn't expect that.
Did not expect the rapper.
Okay.
He's doing just fine. He's on time. He's on rhythm.
But this style is not modern. You know, his rap sounds like maybe 15 years ago.
Yeah.
But I like it. It's more like experimental, you know? It's different from other songs.
I think it's more interesting to watch, too.
Okay, that was great really good. Potential and the voice.
Really good. She hit that note very well. She hasn't hit a lot of the notes perfectly and square
on.
A little bit pitchy. We don't know what it sounds like there. But that big note, she hit that perfectly. She did that 10 out of 10. So this is Malta. What's their national language?
Yeah, they're supposed to do like half of song on their native language.
60% in their native language. I'm assuming it's not English.
So what can I say? I feel like her vocals have great potential, but it was not perfect singing.
It wasn't perfect singing, but I mean, we don't even see perfect singing from all the Eurovision contestants. I think that her voice is good. Like I said, she hit that big note really well. The other boy seems like he's a couple years away from being in Backstreet Boys kind of thing. You know, his rap was kind of...
Like at times of Eminem.
A little bit, yeah. And he put a little bit of stank on the American accent. You know, a little bit of urban on the American accent there. So that was kind of interesting. Overall, though, how would you rate their performance?
I'm not sure if I like the song. Like, song for me sounds very outdated. Mm-hmm. Like, it's almost there 15, 20 years behind. Mm-hmm. If they would come in 2005 and such song, it will be...
I agree. In comparison to some of the other songs that we've seen from the other, you know, the few, but the other Junior Eurovision contestants so far.
It's definitely entertaining. It's interesting to watch because two of them. But I feel like this whole thing requires a lot of love and revamp. Mm-hmm. Like, a lot needs to be done to make it really good.
Yeah. Yeah, I wonder how much time has actually been put into it so far. Well, I definitely didn't hate it. I think that it was fine. I wish them luck. But I don't think that would be my number one choice yet.
So far we heard three other songs.
Mm-hmm.
How would look your top?
Well, I think my top would pretty much remain the same as it was.
Poland.
Yeah, I think that. And then I would probably put this in last place right now.
This is what I feel.
Unfortunately. And I like them. I think that both of those kids were very good kids. And I didn't hate the performance again. And I don't want to disparage them. But I would put that probably in last place right now.
I feel the same.
Mm-hmm.
But with good revamp, with good staging, they fix their vocals. Mm-hmm. It could be actually a very, very cool, interesting performance.
Yeah, I agree. I think those children are talented.
It's definitely not boring.
No. All right. Well, that's our review of Malta. Let us know what you think. Let us know where you would place them in the contestants so far as well. Make sure to like, subscribe, and also leave those comments. We'd love to see them. We'll see you next time.